very good morning to you and welcome to our online service for this second Sunday in Lent, a service of morning prayer as we continue our journey towards the cross of Good Friday and to the victory that Jesus won for us on that first Easter. But this Lenten journey takes us towards those events that we'll be remembering in 4 or 5 weeks' time. At this time, of course, as churches, and I'm sure for all of us, we continue to pray for the people of Ukraine and for a peaceful solution to all the conflict that is taking place there, and pray especially for those displaced from their homeland. Let us pray. O Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Hear our voice, O Lord, according to your faithful love.
According to your judgment, give us life.
Blessed are you, God of compassion and mercy. To you be praise and glory forever. In the darkness of our sin, your light breaks forth like a dawn, and your healing springs up for deliverance. As we rejoice in the gift of your saving help, sustain us with your bountiful spirit, and open our lips to sing your praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God forever.
A song of penitence. Have mercy on me, O God, in your great goodness. According to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my offences.
Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin.
For I acknowledge my faults, and my sin is ever before me.
Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight.
So that you are justified in your sentence, and righteous in your judgments.
Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me.
Give me the joy of your salvation. Sustain me with your gracious Spirit.
Then shall I teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you.
Deliver me from my guilt, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. We pray with one heart and mind. So as we rejoice in the gift of this new day, may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. So we come to the set readings for today, the second Sunday of Lent, beginning with some verses taken from Psalm 119. I have longed for your salvation, O Lord. Princes have persecuted me without a cause, but my heart stands in awe of your word.
I am as glad of your word as one who finds great spoils.
As for lies, I hate and abhor them, but your law do I love.
7 times a day do I praise you, because of your righteous judgments.
Great peace have they who love your law. Nothing shall make them stumble.
Lord, I have looked for your salvation, and I have fulfilled your commandments.
My soul has kept your testimonies, and greatly have I loved them.
I have kept your commandments and testimonies, for all my ways are before you.
Let my cry come before you, O Lord. Give me understanding according to your word.
Let my supplication come before you. Deliver me according to your promise.
My lips shall pour forth your praise when you have taught me your statutes.
My tongue shall sing of your word, for all your commandments are righteous.
Let your hand reach out to help me, for I have chosen your commandments.
I have longed for your salvation, O Lord, and your law is my delight.
Let my soul live, and it shall praise you, and let your judgments be my help.
I have gone astray like a sheep that is lost. O seek your servant, for I do not forget your commandments.
I have longed for your salvation, O Lord. Faithful God, let your word be the treasure of our hearts, that we may delight in your truth and walk in the glorious liberty of your Son, Jesus Christ. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen.
Thank you.
Our first reading this morning is from Genesis chapter 17. When Abraham was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to Abraham and said to him, I am God Almighty, walk before me and be blameless, and I will make my covenant between me and you, and will make you exceedingly numerous. Then Abraham fell on his face, and God said to him, As for me, this is my covenant with you. You shall be an ancestor of a multitude of nations. No longer shall your name be Abram, but your name shall be Abraham, for I have made you the ancestor of a multitude of nations. I will make you exceedingly fruitful, and I will make nations of you, and kings shall come from you. I will establish my covenant between me and you, and your offspring after you throughout their generations, for an everlasting covenant, to be God to you and to your offspring after you. God said to Abraham, As for Sarai, your wife, you shall not call her Sarai, but Sarah shall be her name. I will bless her, and moreover, I will give you a son by her. I will bless her, and she shall give rise to nations. Kings of peoples shall come from her. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Canticle, a song of Manasseh. Full of compassion and mercy and love is God, the Most High, the Almighty. Lord Almighty and God of our ancestors, you who made heaven and earth in all their glory,
all things tremble with awe at your presence, before your great and mighty power.
Immeasurable and unsearchable is your promised mercy, for you are God Most High.
You are full of compassion, long-suffering and very merciful, and you relent at human suffering.
O God, according to your great goodness, you have promised forgiveness for repentance to those who have sinned against you.
The sins I have committed against you are more in number than the sands of the sea.
I am not worthy to look up at the height of heaven because of the multitude of my iniquities.
And now I bend the knee of my heart before you, imploring your kindness upon me.
I have sinned, O God, I have sinned, and I acknowledge my transgressions.
Unworthy as I am, you will save me according to your great mercy.
For all the host of heaven sings your praise, and your glory is for ever and ever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Full of compassion and mercy and love is God, the Most High, the Almighty. A reading from Romans chapter 11. Now I am speaking to you Gentiles, inasmuch then as I am an apostle to the Gentiles, I glorify my ministry in order to make my own people jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? If the part of the dough offered as first fruits is holy, then the whole batch is holy. And if the root is holy, then the branches are holy also. But if some of the branches were broken off and you, a wild olive shoot, were grafted in their place to share the rich root of the olive tree, do not vaunt yourself over the branches. If you do vaunt yourselves, remember that it is not you that support the root, but the root that supports you. You will say branches were broken off that I may be grafted in. That is true. They were broken off because of the unbelief, but you stand only through faith. So do not become proud, but stand in awe. For if God did not spare the natural branches, perhaps he will not spare you. Note then the kindness and the severity of God. Severity towards those who have fallen, but God's kindness towards you, provided that you continue in his kindness. Otherwise you will be cut off. And even those of Israel, if they do not persist in unbelief, will be grafted in, for God has the power to graft them in again. For if you have been cut off from what is by nature a wild olive tree and grafted, contrary to nature, into a cultivated olive tree, how much more will these natural branches be grafted back into their own olive tree? This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
O my God, in you I trust.
You are the God of my salvation.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
In you I hope all the day long.
O my God, in you I trust.
Remember, Lord, your compassion and love, for they are from everlasting.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O my God, in you I trust.
The Benedictus. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies and from the hands of all that hate us,
to show mercy to our ancestors and to remember his holy covenant.
This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies,
free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way,
to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us,
to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Continue now by turning to God this day with prayer. So on this Sunday in Lent, we are challenged to have the mind and way of God as made known by Christ. The life God purposes for us is not found in self-centeredness, but by taking the way of the cross, of defeating evil with the costliness of grace. Let us ask God to show us how we must serve Christ and his kingdom, and what taking up our cross will involve. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. We pray for people suffering sickness of body, distress of mind, or poverty of spirit, for all who care for and minister to such needy folk. Let us take up our cross of sacrificial service to the suffering humanity. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. We pray for our own country, giving thanks for all that is good in it and asking that our government leaders and people may truly take the way of giving themselves unstintingly for the good of all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. We pray for the whole family of humankind of every nation, culture, creed and race. We give thanks for being enriched by a world community so richly diverse. May each community respect each other and none be neglected or afraid. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. We pray for the church in every place, that we may be effective as the body of Christ, taking up the cross of self-giving love to prosper his will and his way among God's children everywhere. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. In our prayers today, we think of all those who have departed this life. We remember those that we have known who have died this week, those of our own departed loved ones. May God bring them safely to his everlasting kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. And as we pause for just a moment, let us think of the prayers of our hearts, all that we wish to offer to God this day. Father of an inexhaustible grace, we praise you for receiving these our prayers. Help us to take your way of giving, serving, caring and loving. We make all these prayers through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. The collect for today. Almighty God, you show to those who are in error the light of your truth, that they may return to the way of righteousness. Grant to those who are admitted into the fellowship of Christ's religion that they may reject those things that are contrary to their profession and follow all such things as are agreeable to the same. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
So trusting now in the compassion of God, we pray as our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. May God, our Redeemer, show us compassion and love.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.